Now on Nightbeat, trouble with Muni's new fleet of train cars. Tonight, the discovery that's prompted the agency to make changes. Good evening to you. I'm Veronica Dela Cruz.
And I'm Ken Bassita. Nightbeat's Joe Vasquez live in San Francisco tonight with more on the problem and what Muni's saying about it tonight. Joe?
Well, first thing they're saying, Ken, is they want to make sure everybody knows all the train lines are running as scheduled, including the J line here behind me. But that said, they've had to do some major reconfiguring after a key piece of equipment has been mysteriously breaking. When you catch a Muni train, you are usually riding two trains together, double trains that are held together by a special piece of equipment called a shear pin. But a few days ago, Muni discovered a problem.
But what we noticed on Friday was that one of those train shear pins broke.
Here's a photo of one of the affected train cars. The green arrow on the left points to a working shear pin. The orange arrow on the right shows one that appears to have broken off. Muni spokesman Paul Rose says that break prompted an inspection of the entire fleet of the new trains bought in 2017.
Once we did that, we noticed that one other shear pin had broken on one other train. So really, out of an abundance of caution, we have pulled the two-car new trains off of the street.
Muni says it has 67 new train cars. 40 of them have been in service.
So this would impact those 40 cars. But they're still running. They're just running as single cars.
So right now, the newer trains are still running as single train cars on the J Church line. Muni says older two-car trains are running as double trains on the rest of the service. Meanwhile, the transit system says it is working with the manufacturer to find out what went wrong with the new cars and how they can keep those shear pins from breaking again. Muni insists that these broken shear pins don't present any sort of safety problem for the public. That said, clearly there's concern as these new trains cost millions of dollars and they have a key piece of equipment that just keeps breaking and they still don't know why. Reporting live on the Nightbeat, I'm Joe Vasquez.